You know, I know you've been watching the radar very carefully. Dave Benton just texted me, says it is pouring near Huntington. Where and when do we need our umbrellas?
Well, a couple more minutes for Huntington's thunderstorm. There is a good amount of lightning out in Capel County right now with particular cell. Oh, for sure. You're going to be hearing it for a few minutes. The good news is, though, once that passes by, that's the cold front, and that's going to make it more refreshing as we head into Monday. And right now in Charleston, it's partly cloudy, real, real humid. In fact, it still feels uncomfortable outside at this point in time, and there's these complexes of thunderstorms that have formed in what's left of our summer heat. This is a cell that is right over Huntington right now. A good amount of lightning there close to the Pea Ridge area, also approaching Barbersville along Interstate 64 right now. That's moving east-southeast at about 35 miles an hour, so you get the idea. It's a quick-moving thunderstorm, and here's some good rain into the mountains. The higher elevation, sometimes they do strengthen these thunderstorms a little bit. Parts of eastern Nicholas County now, southern Webster County with a good show of thunder and lightning right now. But the good news is the severe threats are limited. There could be a 30-mile-an-hour wind gust with any particular thunderstorm left, but what we'll be seeing is high pressure coming in, and that's going to bring us a northerly wind out here for the first time in a while. Once we get this cold front through completely, that will make it still hot and warm for at least June standards, but more comfortable. Takes a lot of moisture out of the air with that north wind off of the Great Lakes region, and we will definitely enjoy a good amount of sunshine into Monday tomorrow. So here's Futurecast. We're still going to be seeing these scattered downpours within the next hour or so. In fact, by midnight here in Charleston, we could still be seeing a thunderstorm. This projection kind of splitting us, but the chance is still there for at least a little bit of rain and thunder within the next half an hour. Then as that front passes through 3-4 in the morning, we dry out, we get that morning fog into the mountains, and then down into the valley, some patchy fog as well near the rivers. But Monday will be an amazing day. Just wear the sunscreen if you have to be out and about with that light north breeze and comfortable conditions, at least much more comfortable. It'll still be hot during times in the afternoon, but the humidity will be easier to breathe. That's a good thing. So here we go. Monday night, couple of high clouds there by 6, 7 o'clock. And as we wake up on Tuesday, the wind direction is now coming out of the southwest. So we get a little bit more moisture into the pattern, and there's a few disturbances coming through. A pop-up shower in the northern counties early afternoon, and we're seeing an increase now in rain chances as you head into southeastern Ohio by about 3 o'clock. Now, we're still dry here in Charleston for most of Tuesday, and plenty of sunshine as well. The cloud cover, though, will increase as you get to that ride home into the evening, and maybe a pop-up shower along the Ohio River back into eastern Kentucky, a thunderstorm there, and some of that rain might make it here on time for the Charleston Dirty Birds game at Gomart Park, 6:30 first pitch against Lexington. It will be warm, but the noticeable increase in cloud cover and maybe a spotty rain shower, but nothing to really impact the game by any means. Now, here we go, Wednesday. That's our next storm system. A cold front, another one in fact, will make its way in, and that will set off chances for scattered showers and thunderstorms in a couple of waves or rounds in the morning and then again during the afternoon and evening as that front passes. So very early Wednesday. Notice how these rain showers and storms start to really increase there. Maybe some thunderstorms there 9 a.m. as we get that initial round through by about lunchtime, and then into the evening, a little bit of a low-pressure disturbance could set off some pretty good downpours with heavy rain and gusty winds later on into the evening. That restarts our cycle back into the 80s for Thursday, and hot with only a touch of moisture for Friday and Saturday into the last weekend of the month.